Hi, it's Carly McAvoy. I want to talk about what you need in order to build a confidence interval to approximate the population proportion, P. So first, you need to know that it's a simple random sample. Number two, you need a binomial distribution. And just to remind you what you need for that, a fixed number of trials. Each trial is independent. There are two possible outcomes, like yes, no, heads, tails, boy, girl. The probability remains the same for each trial. Then you have to know the sample size, or the number of sample values, which we call N. There have to be at least 5 successes and 5 failures, so we know the normal distribution will be a good approximation for the binomial distribution. That is that NP is greater than or equal to 5 and NQ is also greater than or equal to 5. The sample proportion P hat, you need to know that. From that, you can find Q hat by 1 minus P hat. You need the confidence level, which allows you to find the critical value, and you need the margin of error. So those are all the things that you need if you're going to build a confidence interval. And I want to talk about confidence interval and the width of the confidence interval in a way that hopefully will make sense to you. And in the next video, we'll do an example where we build a confidence interval. But this one, I'm just talking about them again to help you understand a little bit more about them. Let's say that we know something about a population, and the true proportion of that population was 42%. If we want to be 99% that our interval contains that value, we would make the interval pretty wide so that we could be including more possibilities. So if our true proportion, we think it's between 42%, we might go all the way down to 30 and up to 54. We want a wide interval because we want to be really sure, almost 100% sure. We need a pretty wide interval. And if you look at that down here on the graph, I'm showing you if we think our true proportion is here at 0.42, then we're going to go all the way down to 30 and all the way up to 54 to say we think it's here, but to be really confident, we want to go all the way out this wide. So to be more confident, you have a wider gap there. If you were just going to be 90% sure, then you don't need to maybe have such a big interval. So if you were going to be 90% sure, that's here in the middle, we'd say, well, we think it's 0.42. We're going to go down to 0.34, and we're going to go up to 0.50. We're not as sure. So we might miss something. That's okay, right? So we don't have to cast it as big an interval there. And then in between is the 95. So we would have a narrower interval than the 99, but wider than the 90. And so maybe we'd have an interval out to 0.32. And I just made these numbers up just so you could illustrate the idea. If you're more confident, you have a wider interval. If you're less confident, you don't need a widest interval. And the way I think about it, if you want to be confident that you catch the fish, you throw a bigger net. So if I really want to be super confident, 99% confident that I'm going to catch that value, then I'm going to make sure my net's really big. So if I'm more confident, I have a wider interval. Less confident, I'm going to have a narrow interval. Okay, in the next video, we'll do an example where we build a confidence interval from a scenario. Have a fantastic day, and be sure and subscribe if you want to see my upcoming new videos.